Assalamu alaikum students, I hope that you all are doing very well at your homes and you had revised the previous lecture. In the previous lecture we had discussed about the classifications of computer by size. We had discussed about mobile computers in which laptops, tablets were the examples. Then we discussed microcomputers, mini computers, mainframe computers and supercomputers. Today we are going to discuss about hardware and several other things. So let's get started with today's lecture. Hardware, as you students know that hardware is anything hard that can be touched or feel. So there are different components of a computer as well that can be seen and touched, and that can only be that can be touched and that can be felt, but there are some components which can only be seen, like the software used, the application we use. And hardware are the products like anything that you can touch: keyboard, mouse, monitor, microphone, speakers, scanners, printers, mouse, anything that you can touch is called hardware. So the physical components of a computer system that we can see and touch are called hardware. Input and output devices, storage devices and the central processing unit are examples of a hardware. So any input device like keyboard, scanner or microphone, or an output devices like monitor or speakers or other several output devices, and storage devices like hard disk and like USB or a CD or a DVD or things like that, in the central processing unit, which is inside the monitor, inside the computer. We can touch them, we can see them, we can change them, we can feel them. So that they are examples of a hardware. So let us now learn about some input and output devices that are used mainly for commercial purposes. So let's learn about the hardware, the input devices. Input devices are the hardware. So input devices accept input from the user and convert it into a form that the computer can understand. As I already told you that computers have a language of their own. So computers, they understand a language which we humans cannot understand. So everything that is fed to the computer is first that we tell the computer, it is converted in the form of a computer language. So we use input devices for that. Like we enter, if you enter a text, we use a keyboard. And if we are going to move a cursor, like I'm moving this cursor right now, that's a input device, and I'm telling computer to do something with the help of a mouse or a keyboard. And sometimes if I have to record a voice, I use a speaker for a microphone. So supermarkets, banks, etc. are specialized input devices, use specialized input devices to collect large amounts of data rapidly. So as things progress and as the workload increases, so the kind of memory increases, we use a lot of memory, we use a lot of computers, and we use because the data is present in very, very large amounts. So we have to use larger amount of memories and more input devices for that, to store and to tell the computer to perform certain functions, because the data being processed is at a very, very larger scale. Such devices include barcode readers, magnetic ink character readers, optical character readers and card readers. So these are input devices that used in different institutions, different organizations. We are going to learn about them in detail. So let's first read about the barcode reader. You must have seen barcodes on products like grocery items and clothes. A barcode is a unique combination of vertical bars that are represented product information such as price, place of manufacture, etc. The cashier uses a barcode reader to scan the barcode. So whenever you go shopping, or especially whenever you go to a mart or a store, every product, if you look at the product closely, which have packaging in them, they have several lines, black lines, which are called the barcode, which every product has. Every product itself has a separate barcode, and these products these barcode, they basically store information like what is the price of the items, or when were they manufactured, or where were they manufactured. So whenever, sometimes if you go to a mart and you have to know the price of a particular product, what you do is you just go to a salesman and ask him that I want to know the price of this, for example, a yogurt pack. So he's going to take this barcode reader, and he's going to scan the barcode and then going to tell you that this is the price of the this yogurt, which is written on the which shows on the monitor which is placed in the mart or in the store. So you must have seen that. I'm just going to show you the picture of it. Here is a picture, this is a barcode, and then the code is written over here, and this is a barcode reader. You must have seen it in the hands of a mart, in a salesman, when you want to know the price of some product on a mart or on a store or everything. Next time if you go and to a shop, please look for barcodes on a products. If you have some products at your home, you can look for these lines. These are the barcode which store information about the product. On each purchase item, which gets into the computer, uses the barcode to identify the product. So the information is basically stored in the computer. So whenever you just put this barcode inside the computer just processes the information and tells you that the name of the item is this, and the price of this item is this. So, and the cashier, whenever you go to the cashier, then he uses this barcode reader, and he has a monitor in front of it, and the computer, it shows the price of that item. The second one is magnetic ink character reader. Magnetic ink is a special ink that contains magnetic particles of iron oxide. A magnetic ink character reader can scan characters printed in magnetic ink. This technique is called magnetic ink character recognition. MICR is used extensively in banks because magnetic ink characters are difficult to forge. This makes them ideal for making and identifying checks. So just like barcode reader, there's a magnetic ink reader. As you can see in this check, this is written in magnetic ink. This is not a normal ink. This is a magnetic ink. All these things are written in magnetic ink, which is these are codes that are written in magnetic ink. In the magnetic ink reader, it checks this code, and provides the legitimacy and authenticity of the check, that whether this check is authentic or not, whether it's forged or not. So this is the magnetic reader reads the code, it tells the information to the monitor that it shows the monitor the information on the monitor that yes, this check is from the this code, this particular branch, or this, and this is legitimized, this is legitimate check, this is not a forged or fake check. So this is these are codes that are used. If you see a check book and if you see the check, then you can see this check book reader, the magnetic ink reader. With help of that, we can check the different information about the about that particular check, that which branch does this check belong to, whether it's authentic or not, whether somebody is faking it or not. There's a special ink that contains magnetic particles of iron oxide, which is sensitive to magnetic fields, and it is used in the printing of certain characters on the original document. So this is special ink that is used. If, for example, a document is faked or a document has been forged, and then this magnetic ink, it will not respond to the magnetic fields, the magnetic fields, or what will it will do? It will produce an incorrect code. So this is how you know banks, they kind of check that whether this check is authentic or this check belongs to that particular bank or not. So did you know QR codes are new style of barcodes in square shapes that can store enormous data? Smartphones are able to scan and read QR codes. You must have seen these codes whenever you for example, if you have to connect some device, for example, you have to connect some app from a mobile phone to a laptop. If you have to connect WhatsApp, you go to the website and it will show you this kind of code, this QR code on WhatsApp as well, on your phone as well, and on your laptop as well. So if you want to connect your WhatsApp app to your mobile, to your computer, then you have to the code should be similar. The WhatsApp it will you have to scan this code on the monitor, and it will see that whether the code matches, then the WhatsApp is going to connect it on the laptop. Similarly, there are so many other apps that can be used that can be connected from one screen to another by using these type of codes. You must have seen these kind of codes on many websites, on many other platforms. Optical character reader. An optical character reader is a device to input normal printed or handwritten text. The process first produces a digital image of the text. Character recognition software is then used to convert this image into character codes that can be understood, stored, and processed by the computer. This technique is called optical character recognition. Here is a picture of optical character reader. You're not going to see it very commonly being used in Pakistan or anywhere. It's not very commonly used, so that's why you must not have seen it. But it's a device like this, as you can see in the picture. So what does this device does is, you know, as you can see, then this man is holding a paper. So this machine, this particular device, what it is going to do is it is going to read this text, and then this is going to store this text in this input device, and then you can connect this input device to the computer, and you can transfer this paper, the text from this paper, to your computer, and you can see that on the monitor. So this is basically the job of it, and this is you can also convert the handwritten text to the computer. So how the computer processes is that it first takes a picture of this text, all this text, then there's a software that is installed inside this device that converts this image into character codes. The kind of the characters that are written over on this page are then going to be converted by that software and converted into a language that can computer understand, and then that those character codes will be converted back into text, these characters, they got printed on, and you can see these characters on the monitor. This is called the optical character recognition. So optical basically means, you know, to see something, you know, that can be seen with the eye. So this is basically by seeing, recognize the character by looking at the text or the paper or any other that is provided by them. This is the optical character reader. So the next one is another input device that is used in various organizations, especially in the educational institution, is called the optical mark reader. An optical mark reader is a device capable of reading printed forms used for objective type exams with boxes of circles that can be filled with a dark pencil or ink. When a light beam is passed through such a form, the marked areas reflect less light than the unmarked areas. This way, the optical mark reader recognizes the boxes or circles that are filled. So the technology is called optical mark recognition, OMR. It is commonly used for checking answer sheets of exams that have multiple choice questions. You can see these type of sheets whenever you go to grow up, and nowadays especially when you are solving MCQs, multiple choice questions, you are going to get these type of answer sheets where you just have to circle the correct answer whichever you feel. So you kind of circle the correct answer, so and then the optical mark reader, it kind of checks your answer sheet whether you have written the answers. You don't need the any man to check the answers. The machine, the optical mark reader, is going to check the answers for it. So how does it work? What it does is that when a light beam is passed through such a form, so a light beam is passed through it, the marked areas reflect less light than the unmarked areas. So these dark bits, that's why the students are asked to fill the circle very properly. So when the light passes through these areas, the sheets, these dark areas, like this dark area, it reflects. They reflect less light than the unmarked areas. The unmarked areas reflect more light, and the these areas, the dark areas, they reflect more light. The marked areas, they reflect less light as compared to the unmarked areas. So the optical mark reader checks the questions. If for example, if light passes through here, then this particular area will show more right refraction than these areas. So then it is going to tick this answer that okay, this part, and the student has selected this, so it is correct or not. The information is already stored. So this is how it is checked. It's called the OMR sheet or optical mark sheet, mark reader sheet. So next one is card reader. Card readers are used for reading information stored on cards such as magnetic strip cards and smart cards. As you can see in this picture, information in the form of numbers and characters is magnetically stored on a magnetic strip. When the card is swiped through a magnetic card reader, it reads information quickly and accurately. Exposure to magnetic fields, physical damage, and contact with certain liquids can destroy the information on the card. Smart cards look like magnetic strip cards but contain a small chip instead of a magnetic strip. Most of the credit and debit cards issued by bank nowadays have both a chip and a magnetic strip. They store more data than magnetic strip cards. A smart card reader can read and write data on the card. Petrol companies and departmental stores use smart card to keep track of customers' shopping history. Satellite television companies use smart card in their receivers to store the code that is used to decode satellite signals and display pictures. For example, as you can see in this picture. So these are also input devices that are used by various different organizations. For example, this card reader, people get whenever they, for example, they earn something, they get a card for this. So and the person they is asked to swipe the card and to get their gifts or to get anything that they want. So whatever the information is stored on the card as magnetic strips and smart cards. So whenever they swipe that, the information goes into the monitor and the computer reads the information and tells that yes, this is a correct card, and then they're going to get their gifts and other things, whatever the card is about. So because it contains magnetic, it is made up of, it has magnetic strips, so that's why it can be damaged, and the certain liquids can also damage the card, so you have to be careful. And similarly, you must have seen this whenever sometimes people don't pay in cash, people use cards nowadays. Most people, they use debit or credit cards to pay their bills. So whatever, there is this small magnetic chip, as you can see in this area, and then underneath it. So this is a magnetic card reader, a smart card reader. So whatever happens is that when the cashier takes the card and it puts injects this card or just swipes through the machine, so then the information that is stored in these smart cards, it goes through it, this device, it reads the information, and it just pays the information, and just the bill is paid from this card because information is stored in the form of in a chip and in a magnetic strip. So lots of different companies, they uses these cards to give information to track the customers' information, and banks use this. This, so you must have seen that. So similarly, as you can see, this is a magnetic strip card. These are magnetic strips, and all these strips and these codes and these things, they store data. They are just not lines. They store a lot of data about the customer or about the person, what is that is stored inside the computer. So these are input devices. Whenever you put them inside a inside a device, they kind of input data to the computer. In the computer, it shows the data on a monitor or on a screen. So these are also the new kind of input devices that are introduced in the world right now. So in today's topic, we have covered about in hardware and some input devices. In the next coming lecture, we are going to talk about the output devices and other several other components of the computer. So you have to revise this at your home. And next, if you are not able to understand anything, then we are going to talk more detail about this in more detail in the next coming lecture. So take care and be safe. Allah Hafiz.